Hello everybody, I'm Mr. Morose and welcome back to the town of Lloyd. I've had loads of problems between the last episode and this. The game audio should sound a lot better now. You should be able to hear things a lot more. I didn't realise how quiet things were. So whenever there's talking, you should be able to hear it a lot better. Hopefully this should be good. I recorded the last episode for an hour. It's going to be longer than I thought anyway. And it was completely messed up, so I'm having to do it again. But I weren't brilliant anyway, and I messed things up, so it should be better this time, hopefully. Right, anyway, let's get on with this. Come on.
March 12th, 1938. Renée T., 16 years old. Menarche, aged 12. Housewife. Father unknown, mother a seamstress. Admitted an observation yesterday morning from Pontedera. Accompanied by a police officer authorized by the examining magistrate of the Court of Pisa to be admitted for a psychiatric evaluation, which I have carried out. Medical certificate. Mental illness preceded by warning signs. Has suffered from depression for a year, believing she had tuberculosis. Food deprivation.
We can't read this document. It is forbidden. We mustn't. If they find out, there will be trouble.
It talks about Renée, it talks about you should read it. Don't be scared, nothing will happen to you. That's true, we should not read it. Let's read it.
Why not? Have you ever wondered who you are?
Yep, all the time.
Of course you've wondered.
A relative may be your child, I don't know. It doesn't matter, I'm here for you. See, I think.
Will you help me to understand? To escape this dazzling light inside me that stops me from seeing?
Of course I will. Of course we'll turn off all the lights together. How can I help you if you don't want to be helped? Bees appropriate for all things, but anyway, that one. Aye.
She is frightened, hears noises and ghosts. Presents serious signs of anxiety psychosis. Suffers from hallucinations. She is anxious, confused. Her expression is distressed. A questioning look as if terrified. Disoriented. She feels confused. Hears voices shouting in her head. She doesn't understand things properly. She has been feeling unwell for 2 or 3 months. When questioned, she replies, "My mother wants to hurt me. I am always scared of her. She chases me. Why are you here?" I argued with my mother and was so upset that I felt like my head was spinning. There was a woman there who wanted to force me into a life of prostitution. They wanted to condemn me to be burned at the stake. Children whispered, called my name. March 16th. She couldn't sleep last night. They wanted to condemn her to be burned at the stake. April 4th. Transferred to the calm ward, still under my supervision.
Yes, that's true. The ward where Amara was. Yes, the stake. The children wanted to burn Renée. She had to pay for what she'd done. Like witches at the stake.
Okay. Was this what frightened you? They were just hallucinations. What had you done to deserve to be punished? We see.
April 21st. She's more awake this morning and is responding to questions, complains of headaches. She became agitated when she found out her mother was there. She says that one day, many years earlier, she was with a friend of hers and met a man who made her get into a car and took her for a ride. He made her smoke cigarettes and drink liquor, and the man showed her certain things. He tried to hurt her and made her go crazy. She says he promised to marry her and made her swear to keep what had happened a secret. These facts were essentially confirmed by her mother. After that, she became arrogant, impatient, and hostile towards her family, especially her mother. She started taking off her clothes in public. Her moods would swing from laughter to tears. She rants, She pleasures herself. I can't remember these things, only the guilt, the stake. I know I deserve to pay for that guilt. I know it even then.
Okay, let's look at the rest of the clinical diary to understand. Everything will become clear. You deserved it because you tried to hide it from yourself. I don't know whether these choices have any bearing on the story. I'm really not sure. I think look
she
at the
was uncooperative during the examination. She didn't want to be stripped, and her body remained rigid. Voluntary attention almost totally absent. Probable hallucinations. April 25th. Confused ideas. Unable to maintain a spontaneous conversation. Reflexes all normal. Reactive pupils. Let's find Amara, and we'll find the full medical records.
Okay. Oh, excuse me. Wind. It's taking some dark turns, this is. Right. At least I know what I'm doing this time. I got a bit lost in the other recording, so that's an improvement. I'm a bit mad it didn't turn out very well, though. It turned out terrible. Right. Yeah, I was wandering around here for ages trying to figure out where I've got to go. And, okay. At least the game audio is better now, so you can hear it better. It was too quiet on the other one, didn't like it. Hopefully this should be better. I apologise for the traffic noise in the background, it's just too damn hot here at the minute. Here we go. Yeah, it took me ages to find that
this
door.
This is the road we used to take. If it weren't for her, in the grounds on that bench in spring, so many days. It was like escaping the nature. She talked and smiled. And then there were the kitchens. Sometimes we stole food and ran back to the bench to eat it in secret. And we laughed.
Okay.
She did things to me. Sometimes she touched me. In the shower, I felt her body against mine for the first time.
That was part of Tatty Bojangles.
It was a shiver that warmed my soul. Eyes closed, the light slipped away.
Right, where were we? This way. Going this way, I think.
She wasn't in the system. He wouldn't let her in. That's it. She must be the key to my memories, to the reasons why.
Chapter 6A, Achievement Unlocked.
The scent of spring. The land of light was far away, and we spent the days chatting on the stone benches.
I love how it keeps flicking to the different artwork. Awesome drawings.
This was our bench. We often went to the kitchens. She sometimes went on her own when things were going well.
Beautiful building. Yeah, I'm expecting things to take an extremely dark turn. They've been quite dark already. Okay, can we get through there? Yep. Just flashes of pictures, memory. Oh, flowers go away. Flowers. way. Okay. Can we get any silver green? I just don't think you can. No. Okay. And the door closes.
Come on. Come on, let's look everywhere. She must be here, I'm certain.
Okay, calm yourself down. Lights and more lights.
We can't go down there. There's too much water.
Ah, okay. Ah, paper.
Adele, that little girl has been standing motionless in front of the kitchen door for hours.
That little
thing, I gave her some candy. She ate it without a word and remained motionless. I don't think she's very well. We used to see her now and again, but now she's always there. I'm going. The doctor's not here. He's coming this afternoon. Try and speak to him.
Sorry about that. Right. Okay.
Lost in her dreams. She was only a little girl. But nobody gave her a cuddle. They punished her instead. They said she was sick, and her dreams were troubling her. They weren't even hers anymore. I need her. But we will find her. We'll find her, won't we? When the water in the shower was cold, we ran away. But when it was hot, then she came to Renée under that cruel white light. I can still feel the shivers her body gave me. Everything must return to how it was. If we recreate that magic, she'll come to us.
Okie dokie. Yeah, this was a bit I already did, so I know what I'm doing here. Close. Right, okay. Power on. Make sure the doors, locks are closed, I think. If I do anything. Ah, button. Press the button. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I wanted this to be all completely blowing, but hopefully it'll be a little bit better now. I don't know what's... Okay, now what? I thought this door should be open. Okay, now what? Close. Don't know why I'm closing then. Close. Ah, I know what I've got to do, I just remembered. I do wish you had a sprint button, but damn, it's warm here. Okay, there's a tap somewhere or something, if I remember right. Come on, where are you? No. In here, I think. There we go. Yeah.
Now everything
turn.
Is ready. We can go to the bathrooms. We can go along that narrow corridor in the kitchens. We'll meet her in the showers, yes.
Don't know if it does anything turning all of them, I don't think. So, but... Oh, itchy. Chin. Right, okay. Love this. There we go, the door's open now. I've only seen a little bit more than this. So. Still love her voice in the atmosphere, and this is amazing. Right, okay. Hold on a minute. Ah, yeah. Which way do we go? I actually remember which way I'm going now. This way, I think. Ooh, that looks nasty. just love how it keeps interjecting with pictures when you walk in somewhere. Open. I just want to make sure I don't miss anything. I think I'm pretty much up to where I was. Rooms just in case. Open says me, open says me. Surgery C. Okay. Right. There we go. Creepy. Love how I can just hear the sound of your footsteps. Open, open. Anything in there? No. Locks. Yeah.
Everything's ready. Let's get undressed and leave our clothes on the hooks in the changing rooms.
Okie dokie. Will do. Well, now varnish. Wonder if we're ever going to see ourselves in the mirror, or...
Let's turn the water on now, and everything will be as before.
Yep, I love the look of this as well. Everything's sort of twisted and bending. Where's the tap? Where's the tap? We'll just walk past it more and more. Where is it? Ah, it's there, right next to me. I'm an idiot. I've done this last time as well, I just completely forgot. Walk around looking for it, it's right next to me. Whoa, there we go. Oh, that's not good. These have seen better days. Whoa, got stuck. They certainly don't look well. Hello. Moving really slowly. I ain't touching any, doing anything there.
Amara was everything I could have been, but she no longer existed. I'd have loved to erase everything I did, but instead I always went ahead and did it again. It was my fault that she disappeared from my life.
That's not good.
They gave you injections there, which made your body and soul tremble violently. A whirlwind of anguish and unbearable pain. I lived in terror of the next time. They had taken me upstairs to that ward where no one wanted to go.
Okay. So I think this is as much as I've seen last time. So we've got to go upstairs then, by the sounds of it. Right. Let's make sure I don't miss anything. Try not to. But yeah, I was saying before, I thought this was going to be short. And I was halfway through it, I was wrong. I checked out a progress I've done. and there's still a hell of a lot more, so it's going to be quite a long game, I think. Yeah, I thought it was going to be just a short story, but which is good. Looking forward to it, seeing where it turns, seeing what happens. Hopefully it'll turn out good, but I doubt it. Right, back upstairs, I think. What time is it? Check on time. Surgery C. Surgical ward. No. Okay. Still creepy that doll isn't sitting there. Hold on, I just thought. Surgery 7. Where's 7? Straight, is that straight in front of me? It is, ain't it? There. Surgery 7, I think. Is it there? Surgery. Ah, yeah, it is. Okay. This. I'm sure it's had a good surgery C. Maybe I'm wrong. Ooh, nasty. Right, okay, what have I got to do? Anything? Maybe I'm wrong. I'm sure it's had surgeries upstairs. Nothing. What's that?
June 1935. After much theorizing and practice in clinics for the privileged, the moment for action has finally arrived. Volterra is the right place. It's an avant-garde hospital, the perfect place for a doctor who really wants to make a difference. November 20th. Crossing the threshold of the asylum was similar to entering another dimension. A world of smells, noises, and images, which it is almost impossible to imagine, describe, or explain. August 1936. The situation is similar to that in many other institutions. The department is overcrowded. Hundreds of patients are supervised by a handful of nurses, who are forced to tie the more distressed ones to their beds or to radiators. They do 24-hour shifts. It's impossible to work like this. We doctors rarely see the female patients, and it's the nurses who tell us what's happening to the women. The overpowering stench in the wards, the constant din of shouts and voices that are barely recognizable as human, dirty, naked bodies devoid of any dignity. The lunatic asylum gets under your skin and wears you down. I often consider resigning. I feel useless, impotent, a sort of merciful jailer, a mercy that helps no one and only helps to ease my conscience. March 15th, 1938. Dramas are played out before my eyes every single day, and I try to distance myself from them and just do the best I can. But a girl arrived some days ago. I couldn't avoid her gaze. All she asked in her dignified silence was not to be ripped away from her world. And me. I'm old enough to be her father, the father she never had, who didn't want her, who rejected her without even knowing her. I too refused what she asked me. I couldn't do anything but add my signature and consign her to hell. A danger to herself and to others, and a cause of public scandal. This was what was written on the accompanying note from the police headquarters. It was difficult not to agree with it. How much more violence must this poor girl be subjected to? Her gaze is so intense, so far removed from the carefree nature which should be the joyous hallmark of her age. I cried myself to sleep in my solitude. I kept thinking about those sad and frightened eyes staring at me.
This links back to them when we was being asked the ABC questions earlier. Pardon me, I think. Now what? Okay. So investigate here, just to make sure there's nothing here. Just try room A. Anything? Noises in the background. I wonder if that's going to unlock at some point. Okay, open. X-rays, anything in the cupboards? Transfer documentation for patient. Oh, shit, let me jump. Okay. Another one of these. Come on then. Click, click, click. No, anything? No. Okay, nothing. I'm sure that it really looks like a gas chamber, a mini gas chamber or something. Oh shit. Okay, I guess we gotta go this way then. The door just flung.
When there was too much chaos, they closed all the windows and the door. They turned off the lights, and it was pitch black. Some people fell asleep, some others stopped seeing their demons and became more calm.
Horrible sounds. Whoa. Okay. Music's amazing. Whoa. Creepy pictures. Okay. Right. The music's beautiful in the atmosphere. And screams, man. Imagine being. Whoa. Okay. What have we got around here? Picture. What we got here? Anything? No, no. And them screams. There's gotta be something here, surely. Nothing. There's gotta be something here. Maybe there ain't. Am I meant to? Right. it's the only other door that's open. Okay. Ah, hold on. Go this way. Screams. Don't know what to do. I just want to get out of them screams. Locked. Nothing to do down there. I thought there would be. Damn noises. Can you imagine being subjected to that? I mean, some of the noise in prison is really bad as well, but agitated women ward. I swear there's something to do down there, but been in there. It's just following me everywhere. Just following me. I'm just closing everything, so I don't know whether that's what the idea is, or I thought they'd finally stop then. I don't know if the audience close everything or open it, I'm not sure. Please stop. Please stop. It's just following me everywhere I go. There's got to be something I've got to do, I don't know. Come on. Stop screaming. I've been in here before. Seems to be getting worse. Do I go back outside? Sure what to do. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I don't know if it's showing up as much on the recording as I'm hearing it, or if it's affecting you as much, but man. More creepy noises here. Well, I'm going to end in a minute, I think. Just like to be able to find out what to do, but I'm not sure. All the way down to there, a minute. Does it look really light down there then? It's gone dark now. What's that on the wall? Anything? Funders. Not funders of the game. Certainly got the atmosphere good. Awesome. Creepy as hell, but awesome. I do wish it was a little bit better explaining what you've got to do next. Maybe I'm just being a bit dense, which is probable. I'm going to try and go outside again in a minute. Got to get out of this noise. This better recorded turned out alright now, so I'm going to be mad as hell. I'm going to be nearly as mad as these lot. That ain't funny, but... oh well. Yeah, there we are. Right, out. Outside. It's gonna follow me outside, ain't it? It is. What am I gonna do? I really don't know what I'm gonna do.
Nature helped me to forget, to escape from the system.
Okay. Okay, right. Why doesn't it always have to follow me everywhere? I suppose that's kind of the thing, it does follow you no matter what. Come on. Get up. It's getting a bit jittery about that. Back through there. I definitely think there's something I've missed back there. It's gotta be. Oh, hey up. I didn't know if you could get in there. In there. Ah. I'm thinking maybe I've done the opposite of what I should have done. I'm thinking maybe I should have opened everything, but I don't know. Everything that I could open. That's bolted. Everywhere. Go this way. Oh, I'm the end in a minute. Shrieking. Oh, back here. What? Something. What am I missing? What am I missing? Come on. Be good to me. Stop screaming. Ah. Can't get that. No. Come on. Open. Don't know. Really don't know what to do. Open. No. Come on. Open. No. Quick wander down here. Come on. Right. Switches. No. Lights. Turn on. Open. Open. Around here. Open. Open, nothing, no. Please stop the noise. Please. Come on, I wanted to get to a major checkpoint. I don't know. I think it said I got 6A. It's back there, that's back there. Come on. Funders page. Open. Get there, open. Just not stopping. I don't know what to do. Help me. I don't know what to do. Tell me what I've got to do. Tell me. Closer to them. Yeah, open that. Yeah, and yeah, come on, open. Thank you. No, open. Stop the shrieking. It's locked. Come on. What have I got to do? Oh, what was that? See the clicky noise then? Ah, hold on. Oh, Oh, this is just back round to there. No, I don't want to go back up, don't I think. I don't really, but... Come on, open, open. What am I gonna do? Help! What to do? Ah! Hold on. That one opened before, that's the front door. Okay. So I can now get out the front door. I don't know what I've got to do. It's really weird. I thought the stop for a second then. Damn it. Right, what can we do out here? Anything? Can we run off? Just get me away from the noises. I'm gonna have to end up in Grenades, I just realised. I'm just trying to figure this next bit out. I'm gonna have to do it next time. I can't jump or do anything. Right, so quick wander down here really quickly, and then I'm gonna end. Noises are starting to drive me mad. Seriously. Really bad. Which way? This way. Can't escape them. Right, I'm going to end here. Try to figure out what the hell I've got to do. I've been Mr. Morose, this has been the Town of Light Part 2. I was hoping to get more done, but I've got stuck again, unfortunately. Like, comment and subscribe if you feel the urge, I'd really appreciate it. Oh, them noises, man, I swear I'm going to be hearing them for days. I just don't know how to make them stop. And remember, be excellent to each other and stay safe out there. Cheers for watching if you did. Oh, cheers. Bye. Bye.